Welcome to kenandrinse.com. I am Darren Gargette, and this is a garden. Not any garden, no. This one is populated with piñatas. Viva piñatas, maybe. Yes. Yeah, so this is the PC version of Viva Piñata 1. There are three in total, possibly four. But yeah, there's this one, there's Trouble in Paradise, which is the pseudo-sequel, or more of a refinement of this game. And then you have the Trouble in... I just said that. Pocket Paradise. There we go. Which is the portable game for the DS, which is also very good. But yeah, every now and again I get this itch to play Viva Piñata. And the itch come along, I'll be honest. And here it is. Oh, there's a bit of a hole there. In my pond. So what we have here is a sort of, again if you want, like a god game. But, like, you know, it's not actually like on a massive planet where you're like populous or anything. But it's that kind of genre where you're overlooking a certain theme. Instead of a theme park or a zoo, it's a garden full of piñatas, and they all interact with each other. And there's like an ecosystem going on where you have to, like, to get the heart above the sparrow mint, you have to get the sparrow mint. Do you see what they did there? Spearmint, the sparrow, to eat the worm. But then you want to be careful because you don't want to run out of worms. So what you do, you make the two worms have romance. And when you do that, they do a little dance, see? And then it goes to like a little mini game. And here, it's sort of like an innuendo. It's sort of, you know, a bit of a metaphor for sex, you know what I mean? Get the worm through the hole. Get the cotton. No, it's not. it kind of is. It's just like, you know, instead of them, you know, proper penetrating each other, it's all about just getting the one animal to the other, Pac-Man style. And they've all got their own mazes, and the harder the maze refers to the better the animal. God, my English there was incredible. So here we have a fudge hog. We can check out his basic stats. We can name him if he wants. Where is that basic info? We can rename him to I don't know. Fudgehead. I don't know. Why not, eh? Can do that. We can also get our spade out, which, you know, that's up on the D-pad, or, you know, if I wanted to just do it the old school way, you can go to the menu by pressing X. I'm playing on the 360 pad. I try playing mouse and keyboard, but it's nearly impossible because obviously the game was designed for 360 and then ported over to PC, and this port is not the best. So yeah, we've got the watering can, which I can use left on the D-pad. As you can see, it's left there. The surface packets, which is grass and long grass and stuff like that, or the shovel. So we're going to select the shovel now, and I waited to do this quick rinse until the garden grew at level... One second, let me check the level I'm on. Down the bottom left there. Level 11, that's right. So my garden has just expanded in size. So, you know, I can show you, like, you know, how to sell stuff and stuff like that. So if I click in the left stick, I can move my cursor around quicker. Can I sell that? Can I? It's a Banjo-Kazooie statue! Oh my god, that's amazing! Okay, cost a quid. I don't want to get rid of it, but it's a bit, yeah, it's junk. I'm only keeping it because it's got Banjo-Kazooie on it. So yeah, we want to get rid of all this crap. Are you selling? All the buttons in the top right-hand corner, they tell you what to do. So press the red to sell, checkout, yes. And there's a few too many steps in the sell process for my liking. But, you know, it's easily done. You don't have to listen to her every time. Are you sure you want to clear all this out? I love the music in this game. Surprise, surprise. The Banjo-Kazooie 2 make a game, and I love the music. There's a surprise. Yeah, so let's fill up the hole. Fill the pond by pressing the A button. As you can see, it's all context sensitive. Oh, hang on. Like, you know, you can put your spade over the little worm there and smack around the head if you want to. Just sort of tell them off. Like, when they start fighting, if they ever do fight. There's the sour bat! There's the evil piñatas that drops sour sweets everywhere. Okay, looks like we've got away with that. So let's fill these ponds up that are intruding into my game. And this one. Oh, hang on, there's a fight. Let's go there. Who's fighting now? Oh, Fudgehog versus the worm. It's gonna have a look proper. Oh, so yeah, the piñatas don't often get on. Let's plant a seed quick before it goes out of date and mouldy. Yeah, but I don't really want my fudgehogs to get beaten up by the worm. I mean, the worms are like the most basic pinata, so I can't see him losing this fight, this fudgehog, but there's always that chance. I'll let him get to it. Bollocks to him. We can always call the doctor out to sort them all out, basically. Right, this frog's pond is a little bit rubbish since I built their house. It sort of created extra land, and I don't think the frogs are too happy with that. Yeah, the thing with Viva Piñata is that I always get to a certain point where it just becomes too much, and I get overwhelmed. So what I'm trying to do is not just trying to rush straight to the end game with the piñatas. I'm just trying to keep my money up. Oh, hold on, I can't put grass in there, can I? Because I've got. Who won? Okay, the worm won. I'm not too bothered about that. No, the worm lost. Sorry. Alright. Oh, they're still fighting it. Oh, I don't know what's going on. Yeah, this port isn't the best. It's a bit buggy at times. So yeah, every time you have a new animal visit, like the badgercle here, this is a new guy, it asks you it tells you the requirements for you to, you know, make him a resident. So he needs to eat a type of, I nearly said Pokemon then, piñata, and then once he's a resident, they get all the colour. And then on the right-hand side there, you can see the romance requirements. So you need to have like a certain amount of this and a certain amount of that. And they've all got their own sort of attributes or requirements. So like, you know, the snake, he will be a resident once he gets to eat a marshmallow. But I haven't seen a marshmallow yet. The liquor toad, he's now a resident because he's got his colour. But to romance, he needs to eat a green flutterscotch. Now, if you go to the flutterscotches, which are always in the house... Oh, dickheads! Like, it took me ages for them to get sexy time on, because they just kept flooding their house. And you can look inside their house if you want. You just go, yeah, hi guys, having fun. But every time I use my spade to smack the house, they go in one at a time. They come out one at a time, and then they go back in, and I wasn't happy. Right, so I whack the hard soil, make it sort of soft soil so we can plant. Can I hold down the A button here? I can't I? Yeah, here we go. Another pond there, need to get rid of that. Sherbet there, sour sherbet. So yeah, the sour ones will drop like sour sweets and poison your aura. They said Pokemon again, piñata. And this game's, I don't know, this game's got a certain rare quality to it. Now, everyone moans about it, you know, not being the next Banjo-Kazooie or whatever. But again, like, Rare have knocked out another game that's amazing. Like, this game is really good. And while it's not as good as the, you know, the spiritual sort of redo, which is Trouble in Paradise, it's still brilliant. Oh, hang on. Yeah. Is it? Oh no, look at Toadil. Oh, we need to get him sorted. Call the doctor. Cost me 60 quid. I'm sure it's not. Yeah, I'm happy for you to do that. So what I'm doing so far is just padding out this hard soil to make it oops. Making it soft so I can put grass on it. Because it looks a bit rank at the moment. Apple tree there, giving me some apples. Could sell them. I think I will before they go mouldy. The one problem I've got with the garden expanding is that all of a sudden you've got this garden that's looking pretty shit. Like, oh, no. Like, you know, because obviously the boundaries was here before, but they've expanded the garden. So now I've got this extra spare room that doesn't look good. like, you know, when you like furnish your house or anything, you put the sofa against the wall, and I just imagine someone just kicks down the wall behind your sofa. There's just this gap behind your sofa now, and you're like, well, cheers for that. You know what I mean? I'd much rather I don't know. I wish it pushed that to the back, so then there's more play. Because you can't move these things, I don't think. Menu. I can't move them. So look, they're just stuck there. Whereas I'd rather have that against the wall. You know what I'm saying? It's a bit annoying. I think that's something that got rectified in Traveling Paradise, to be honest. Oh, that's more of this hard soil. Yeah, this game on PC is £2. as you can see there, the friends list for Xbox Live is popping up. And while the achievements aren't super easy to get, this game definitely is an achievement game. Hold on. You know, like they're sort of like your guidelines to success. You want to keep your eyes on them. We can sell anything we want in the game. So if we highlight all these things by pressing B, 1, 2, and like you see on the left there, it's accruing. 2, 3. And it puts the little Mrs. Costalot, whatever she's called, her face above all the things you want to sell. You can even sell, like, piñatas, and you say Pokemon again. But, I don't know, I sort of don't want to sell the fudge dogs because they're quite rare. Well, they're not rare, but, you know, they don't come on along. Yeah, I am, yeah. They don't come along very often. If we get the seed packet out, we can start pouring grass everywhere. And again, it's just this, like, the fact that you can just do this as opposed to just, like, I don't know, I imagine at one point in this game was just, like, keep pressing A to pour the seeds. And it's just these little things that make the game a lot easier to use. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this is so much fun. It's like, you know, it's just like painting. And hopefully the more grass we get. Hello, 40. I'm sure that was Plexure that just came online as well. Grass. The more grass we get, the more chance there are of piñatas, not Pokemon. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble. Hello? That was a evil sweet. Need to keep our eyes out for that. Where is it? Oh no, so they're going to eat it if I don't find it quick. Hang on, there he is. There's the evil sweet. Now, there is a way of making these guys friendly, but I'm not really too bothered about that right now. I know, but you're evil. I mean, you can't help it. It's the way you are, but... Right then, so if we go to the village here, I just found out, by the way, I can press F2 to get that up immediately, which is really nice. Because that's one problem with this game, is you end up dicking around in a lot of these menus. And near the start of the game, up to level 11, there's just cutscenes all the time, like, especially when you do something really good, and like it gives you a couple of levels, like, straight away. It will just start piling on these cutscenes, you're like, yeah, okay. Jesus Christ, get on with it. Let's sell this blackberry quick. Might as well get the money for it. Right, focus. I need to know what to do next. I think I'm going to get these fudge head and fudge hog 2 to have a baby. What is that? That is amazing. Yeah. So we need a bottle of milk. And a question mark, which I assume that is you need their house. But first, we need the bottle of milk. Which is they're quite expensive bottles of milk. So yeah, this is Costalot's store. It's where you can buy all your bits and bobs, so fertilizer, watering cans. Have we got another watering can to buy? Nah, got the gold one. Seed packet seeds. Yeah, got the long grass. Pavings. Vegetables, you can just buy vegetables, or you can grow them yourself with the seeds, which are over here. It's always wise to grow them yourself because... words? Because you get experience for growing flowers and plants that you haven't grown before. Let's pop this here. Check out. Yeah, return to items. Let's get a chili seed. I like keeping all my flowers together and stuff, so we'll keep them. Plop this here. Oh no, I didn't mean to buy two. That's right, you can always undo. That's right. So yeah, I've just planted two new seeds there. Hopefully get some experience from that. Bottles of milk. Oh man, 1,400. There's got to be a way of getting that by myself. Garden items. could put these blocks down to stop them from coming in, I guess, but... Milk churn. I guess I need a piñata to make me milk first before I start churning it. Okay, right. Give me a second. We're going to romance some worms. And then we're going to romance some sparrow mints, sell them on, and buy 2 bottles of milk. And that's the problem with this game, I think. It's just so easy to get overwhelmed. Because there's so many piñata going on in your garden at once. It's just like, well, I need to do this, this, and this. And then there's a point where you need to get rid of the worms, but they're sort of like your bread and butter. Like you do this so many times, it's ridiculous. I kind of wish at some point that you become a master romancer of the guys. Of the worms, the sparrow mints, you know, you do it so many times, you become like the master of it. I just wish that it removes the minigame, because it's a little bit of a chore after a while. But you have to do it to keep the ecosystem alive, you know. Let's water this before. So A to do a short pour of water, just one, or the blue to do a long pour. You don't want to overwater your flowers, for obvious reasons. Come on, have a baby. I know you just have one, but have another one. Alright, well that's already got a heart above him. So if we get that one to eat that one. And then we'll get these 2 sparrow mints to, you know, do the do. And then we'll sell them on. Yeah, look at this. That looks awesome. This game still looks amazing. I think it looks better on Xbox because of this port. Here we go. Award for growing a toadstool. Bingo. Right, we'll get these 2 to do the bonk and then we'll sell off the baby. That is really weird, I tell you. Oh, what happened to him? Did he eat the toadstool? He did, didn't he? What a nugget head. So yeah, like you're pretty much just like farming these animals. I know it sort of is a farming, maybe, but you sort of feel a bit dirty. Like, you know, I'm literally just making these 2 do their do. Well, watch this bit of design genius from the user interface here when I get around here. Look. Get in my coins, get in my coins, get in my coins. Yep. And here we go, through the tricky part of the maze. Oh yeah, that's it. You put your speech bubble right over my face, you idiot. Luckily, I am wicked, bruv. Yeah, so like you're literally doing this, like, you know, forced mating ritual to make money. It does feel a bit weird after a while, do you know what I mean? Oh, little froggy's ill, man. Because he ate the toadstool, I guess. But he's the toad, I suppose. I don't eat my chairs, do I? You should have just sat on it. Yeah, these are like your messages down the bottom. They are really useful in the early game, but you sort of get used to the, you know, what's going on. Yeah, my garden, by the way, is never ever tidy. It's the same with like theme hospital and stuff. It's just like, it's just functionary. You know what I mean? I don't have the ability to create or design a decent looking garden. It's just a garden. I've seen some gardens that look amazing. I'm pretty sure my old buddy Testers at Rare would have made the best garden imaginable. Oh, I've got a new Taffly resident. That's nice. Where is he? There he is. I'm not really into them right now, so we'll sell him off. I think that's the way to play this game. It's just like focus on certain sets of dudes, you know? Rather than trying to get every single type of piñata to, like, you know, have a baby and stuff, like, just keep your bread and butter, your worms and your sparrow mints, and then every time a new one comes along, just focus on it. So, like, these liquor toads, maybe I could just get rid of them, because I'm not really bothered about mating them just yet. Oh, hang on, my chili was a bit withered there. Din, 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 din. You see at the top there, right? That coin is apparently worth 10. But it looks exactly the same as the one that looks like a 1. I can only assume that's a port issue with this. Done by Climax, how do you know? which is weird. The guys usually make Silent Hill games. Not always. Sell the apple. See, look, we've got this snake here called Syrupant. And, you know, he's got to eat the marshmallow, as I said earlier. We've got a guy called Sidos here. When you talk to him. Oh, shut up. Just give me your seed. There's actually a speech dialogue where he says, "You don't want to talk to me, you just want my seeds." And I was like, well, yeah. My chili. No! Oh! Cost me money. There's a bunny comb over there, look. Come in my garden, man. Moth drop, what do they need? They need to eat a thistle. Have I got a thistle? Yeah, that's a thistle. I've got loads of moth drops. I can sell one off. Wow, they're worth a lot. Right then, let's get the house for the fudge hog. Maybe, my friend. Yeah, fudge hog home. Right, so then we choose the home and we press the X button to rotate it. See the door there at the front? That lets you know where the front door's going to be. That's interesting, isn't it? Let's place it down. I am. He'll come down and build this for us. He should come out of one of these buildings nearby. Look at the world around me. In Trouble in Paradise, you can actually go to these other areas, and there's like a trapping mini game or something where you lay a trap and you catch piñatas. Jesus. Right, moth drop. Oh, come in, moth drop. That's the problem with these flying ones as well. They're really hard to catch. Oh. Right, moth drop. Eat thistle. I love the music. Yeah, water in that. Probably too much now. Just because you're not happy, mate, doesn't mean you don't eat the thistle. Okay? Go on, go on. You'll end up doing this many times. There we go. So, moth drop. Do to do with the moth drop. Where are my fudge hogs? There's fudge head. Ah, oh, dirty shats. Shirt bat. There's the other fudge hog. You. Out. Sorry, guys, but I'm not losing a fudge hog because of a dirty shirt bat. Six. 5, 4. It's like opening a new Costco or something, or a Tesco's or something else that ends in co. Cheers, buddy. Oh, the moth drops are doing the thing, aren't they? Oh no, this is a really hard one as well. So in the top left there, you have like the time, the amount of lives you have before, you know, these bombs can obviously take a life off of you, if you couldn't tell by their red glowing faces of evilness. To thread the needle. Oh yeah, I see. You say your little pun there and get in the way. Winner. I'll sell one of them off when another one comes down, like a dirty poacher that I am. Yeah, we use our spade to reveal the building. Bosh. And there we go. So right, that's part one of the fudge hog romance requirements. So we need 2 bottles of milk. There's a little baby sparrow mint cocooning himself up into an adult. Let's watch him. Here he comes. It's exciting, isn't it? I just heard an evil one. Fudge Hulk, eat the chili. He did. What's going to happen to him? Oh. Hang about, I see it. Variant discovered. What happened to him then? He's changed, isn't he? He's a different colour. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, that's how you make them green. There we go, and stuff like that. It's all making sense now. It's been trampled. Naturally, this will make them unhappy. Who's that? Oh, it's only a worm. Jesus. Right then. F2. Cost a lot of store. There's so many of these helper dudes. Like, I just don't know. I never use them. That's probably to my detriment. That's probably to my disadvantage. Alright, 2 bottles of milk, please. Oh, I don't like spending this much money, but it's got to be done. For the quick rinse! Oh yeah, there's a surprise. Fudgehead just sitting in his home. They always just... Oh, they always just go and sit in their home. Go away, Batchicle. We want this one and this one to have a baby! So I can sell it on. Like the dirty, evil poacher that I am. I suppose I'm not a poacher, I'm more of a breeder. But still, it doesn't seem right to me. Oi! Here we go. No, don't go back into the... I just wish there was an option just to block their home off, you know? Just like put a sofa in front of it or something. Because I end up just doing this until they're both out. And... Fun. Get out. I feel like some sort of like pimp, you know. Making them, forcing them to do the do. Come on. Fight between a worm and a spearmint. Here we go. Fudge Hogs are doing it. Gonna do it mixed race style as well, look. One's... What the fuck is that? Oh my god, that's a massive hippo! Oh! I've got to get the hippo in my game. Oh man, this is a bit crazy. I'm just gonna get... Oh no, there's a lot of money involved, but I just want to get to the end. Just, I want to show you the video that plays when they actually, for the first time, when each sort of type of Pokemania does it do. Look at the size of that. Yeah, but when the first So when a pinata for the first time makes a love in your game, you'll see like a little video of them doing it in the house. It's wicked. Here we go, this is it. Going on. I must admit that's the most boring one I've seen. Sorry about that. Oh, here we go. Look, another person to get in the way.
Well, hi there. And how are you today? How's your garden? Making good profit? You know, gatherings like me can go around picking up and selling all.
Shut up. I know it is. I'm level 12. Right, let's call the doctor. Oh, healing a worm. Oh, it doesn't seem right to me. Right then. Get these worms to do the do. Again. When I said this game is all about the achievements, I'd let you know that they're all pretty much secret. So, I don't really like that with this game. Because it sort of needs to be your guide. like oblivion, you know what I mean? Like whenever you get lost, like, okay, what can I focus on? And that gives you like a certain goal. Yeah, look at him. He's loving it. Okay, little fudgehog baby coming. What was I doing? I got distracted, didn't I? Like, again, by the big hippopotamus. That's probably what it's called, isn't it? Hippopotamus. Oh, come on. Please. Please take an interest in my garden. It looks amazing. Although, I think he would actually eat everyone else in the area. I was going to do something. I've completely forgotten. Yeah, that's what I was going to do. I was going to get a helper. Which is it? Arthur's in? Yeah. It costs like 400 gold to get a helper. Yeah! I've got a barrel for a head! Okay. There we go. Yeah! I got an achievement! Sprinkling. Employed a sprinkling. Okay. So what does this do? I've never done this before. It's probably why I get overwhelmed, because I don't get the helpers in. Here she comes. What a weird character design. Like, even for Rare and the Banjo team, this is, that is weird. I mean, the googly eyes. They've toned down on the googly eyes, but... Hello, CDOS. Give us your seed, mate. Yep, that's right. You can smack him as well with your spade, but he doesn't like it, obviously. What's this? Raisin! Raisin! Yay! I'm going to sell him when he becomes a resident. What was I doing? Oh, yeah. Let's click on you. Information, basic information. Rename. I don't know. Gloop. There you go. It's a bit of a Banjo-Kazoo reference there. Help name caller. That's right. Whoa, hang on. Who dropped the sour sweet in the game? What was that? Yeah, this is Viva Piñata. It carries on like this for as long as you want it to. It's really nice. And again, it's that word that I don't really like using. Yeah, go on, water my plants. Help is amazing. Oh god, sour Shelly Beans having a fight with someone. I'll put an end to this. Yeah, it's such a lovely game to play. It's like a Sunday game, you know, where you can't be bothered to play a game, but you sort of put a Viva Piñata on because it doesn't really tax your brain that much in terms of, like, you know, pure action, explosions and stuff. It's just sit back, relax, play some Viva Piñata, just chill out, enjoy the sun. The sun? Is that the sun? Looks like a bit of fruit. Look at this little dude. Yeah, go on, eat your fruit, man. I just wish they'd do another one, because I'd... No work for sprinkling. Well, you better not disappear. I've paid you. Because I'd play it. You know what I mean? I'd just love them. The Trouble in Paradise is a little bit better, so if you can find that for cheap, get that, because it refines all the problems with this one. But that doesn't make this a bad game in any way. So if you've got a PC that's half decent, go to whatever website, post a bargain, I guess. Type in Viva Piñata, and you'll see it for like £2, and I ordered it, and it come the next day. You know what I mean? £2. Yeah, go on. How many is he eating? I don't tell you. And, like, you know, like, when you actually get into the mood of Viva Piñata and, like, you've got a set goal, like, you know, oh, I'm gonna make these raisins have babies, It the time just disappears. It's fantastic. Here we go. Go on. New Rayzant resident. Is that him? Is the colour going to fill in? Yeah, here we go. He's doing his dance. And because he's worth a grand, we'll set him off. Bless him. But that's the name of the game, I'm afraid. You come into Garden Gargette House Land, then I'm going to sell you. Maybe I shouldn't have that as my motto. Because I should encourage new put piñatas. So thanks for watching this quick rinse of Viva Piñata. It's been a delight to show you the world of my garden that looks like shite. And I hope this has inspired you to check out the game, because I know it's a rare game and it's not perfect dog, but while I sort of agree with you there, it is a rare game in terms of quality and it's amazing. So thanks for watching. I've been Darren Gargette, this is a quick rinse, and I'll be doing some more like normal.